In this video, we will take a look at the characteristics and presentation of a rare but debilitating form of headaches, the cluster headache. Enroll in our online course now. Link is in the video description. Hi and welcome back to PhysioTutors. Headaches can manifest on their own, but are also a very common symptom in neck pain patients, as more than 60% of patients with a primary neck pain complaint report of having concordant episodes of headache. Therefore, it's essential to find out what kind of headache the patient is suffering from. To start off, let's differentiate between primary and secondary types of headaches. But what does this mean? Simply put, primary headaches are a disease themselves, whereas in secondary headaches, the headache is a symptom of another condition. So, primary headaches would be migraines, tension-type headaches, and cluster headaches. Secondary-type headaches are headaches caused by tumors, hemorrhage, other trauma, TMJ dysfunction, substance overuse, or neck pain, aka the cervicogenic headache. Now let's take a closer look at cluster headaches, which are primary type headaches. Cluster headaches have a 1-year prevalence of 53 per 100,000 people around the world, with men being affected around 3 to 4 times more often than women at the age of 20 to 40. In order for a headache to qualify as cluster headache, it has to fulfill certain criteria. A. At least 5 attacks need to fulfill criteria B to D. B. An untreated episode lasts 15 to 180 minutes and shows a severe or very severe unilateral orbital, supraorbital, and/or temporal pain. C. It matches either or both of the following. 1. At least one of the following signs and symptoms, ipsilateral to the headache: conjunctival injection and/or lacrimation, nasal congestion and/or rhinorrhea, eyelid edema, forehead and facial sweating, meiosis and/or ptosis, a sense of restlessness or agitation. There are reports of patients pacing back and forth through the room, banging their heads due to the severe pain. It occurs with a frequency between 1 every other day and 8 per day. Tools you can use to assess the impact of a headache on your patient are, for example, the HIT-6 questionnaire, which you can find in the video description down below. Also note that it can be difficult for a patient to answer all of the questions on duration, intensity, and characteristics of their headache during your initial assessment. Therefore, asking them to complete a headache diary can help in the assessment and management of the headache, and you should be aware that there can be an overlap between multiple headache disorders. Okay, you can check out another headache presentation on the left. Please check the links in the video description down below to learn more about our online course, our ebook, and mobile app. Give this video a thumbs up before you leave. Subscribe if you are new here, and as usual, this was Andreas for PhysioTutors. I'll see you in another video. Bye.